Antonio Brack, Minister of Environment of Peru. Your Excellency, Mr. Antonio Brack, you have the floor.
Buenas noches, un cordial saludo a la mesa
Good
directiva.
Evening. Cordial greetings to the presidency. The world's commitment to reduce the risks of negative consequences of climate change cannot be postponed any longer. We need an immediate agreement. The developing countries consider it is urgent to enforce the right of peoples to sustainable development. It is our duty as leaders to guarantee this, particularly when the impact of climate change will be very harsh on economy, the health and the food security of our countries. Peru looks forward to a global, ambitious and effective agreement to deal with climate change. Peru's position has been and continues to be proactive. It favors an international consensus to ensure compliance with the provisions of the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change and the Kyoto Protocol.
Nuestro país es altamente
Our country
vulnerable
is extremely vulnerable
a los efectos
to the negative effects
del cambio
of climate change.
Y por ello,
and
no puede conformarse
it cannot,
con metas
therefore,
globales
agree
poco ambiciosas
to weak global objectives, which will mean expensive adaptation processes in the future. Peru expects a binding commitment by the developed countries to be ambitious, thus reducing greenhouse gas emissions by 45% by 2020 and by 95% by 2050, taking 1990 as the base year. These commitments should operate within a transparent framework of periodic reviews, be monitorable in terms of the effectiveness of measures taken, and should be readjusted as science moves forward, particularly with respect to the impacts of climate change and new mitigation options. Peru believes firmly that the developing countries, such as ours, can make a significant contribution to the overall mitigation effort with voluntary proposals and ambitious ones in terms of their capacities. These proposals should be designed together to achieve 40% reductions with respect to current emission levels by the year 2050, within a framework promoting mitigation actions in all countries in accordance with the principle of common but differentiated responsibilities and in parallel with support mechanisms and international and national incentives. In accordance with this position, Peru announced at the 14th COP in Poland its determination to reduce the net deforestation rates in its tropical forests to zero by 2020. This would be our country's contribution to global mitigation efforts. Emissions from deforestation in the year 2000 accounted for 47% of our national emissions. This proposal fits into a forest policy which, while conserving our biodiversity and the global environmental services of our forest ecosystems, at the same time makes it possible to reorient the development of our own population better to adapt to climate change and thus to ensure greater sustainability. For this purpose, Peru is contributing its own funds and is at the same time coordinating international support. The initial cost of implementing this policy would be around $350 million per year. Peru values the additional benefits this represents for our country and therefore has budgeted its own resources for monitoring and control amounting to $80 million. $270 million. There is thus a gap of $270 million to be filled each year. This represents 60% of the total funding estimated for mitigation in our country, namely $450 million per year. The actions which Peru has implemented for this purpose are being carried out under our National Forest Conservation Program, including, among other initiatives, the special project known as Conservation Together, which encourages conservation and use of forests by indigenous communities in the country, contributing to the local economy and family economics through a direct payment of $3 per hectare per year. This program will cover 10.5 million hectares of forest. The initiative requires complementary resources, and for that reason, we have appealed for international cooperation to make a substantive increase to this effort and to fulfill the short-term goals. Peru also joins in efforts to reach a political and technical agreement with a view to establishing a RED mechanism in parallel with national efforts and as an additional source of resources. Peru thus demonstrates its determination to take immediate action, and we hope this will encourage other parties to join these efforts to ensure a sustainable future, not only for this generation, sino también para las generaciones futuras. But also for future generations.
En la cumbre número 14,
the 14th
Peru ha prometido iniciar un programa de conservación de los bosques
for forest conservation, and it is putting that into practice. Thank you very much.